गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडेज लेसन इज रॉबिन्सन क्रूसो फ्रॉम यूनिट 3 चैप्टर 2 रिटन बाय डैनियल डिफो। ओके चिल्ड्रन, लेट्स सी द ऑथर इंट्रोडक्शन बिफोर गोइंग टू द लेसन। डैनियल डिफो वाज एन इंग्लिश ट्रेडर, राइटर, जर्नलिस्ट, पैम्फलेटर एंड स्पाई। ही इज मोस्ट फेमस फॉर हिज नॉवल रॉबिन्सन क्रूसो। ही वाज बोर्न ऑन 1660 at London in United Kingdom, and he was died on 24th April 1731 at London in United Kingdom. Okay children, let's see some new words from the lesson. Savages means wild people in primitive state. Mainland means a large continuous extent of land. Wandered means go from place to place without a definite route. And bolder means more confident. Okay children, this is the story about Robinson Crusoe's adventures. His ship had been destroyed by the sea, so he had been thrown to the seashore, and he had been alone for many years and longed for company. One day he discovered a footprint on the sand. Let's find out what he did then. One day, when I was going towards my boat, I was surprised to see the footprint of a man on the sand. I stood amazed. I listened. I looked around me. I could neither hear nor see anything. I went up higher to look down. I went up the shore and down the shore, but it was no good. I could find no other footprint but that one. I went to it again to see if there were any more footprints and to tell if it had been my imagination. But I was not mistaken. For there was exactly the print of foot, toes, heel, every part of a foot. I could not imagine how it came there. I stayed a long time thinking, but became more and more confused. At last, I returned home very frightened, looking behind me after every two or three steps, making every bush and tree to be a man. When I came to my cave, which I called my castle, I ran inside it as if I was being chased. I do not remember whether I used the ladder or went in by the hole in the rock, which I called the door. I ran for cover faster than any animal could run. I did not sleep that night. The more I thought about what I had seen, the more afraid I became. I thought it could be one of the savages of the mainland who had wandered out to the sea in a small boat. Luckily, I was not on shore at that time, but what if he had seen my boat? If he had seen the boat, he would have realized that someone lived on the island and would soon return with others to kill and eat me. And so I lived fearful for many days and prayed for protection. In doing so, I was much comforted and began going out to investigate. But even now, as I went forward, I looked behind me frequently because I was still very frightened. And so I lay fearful for many days and prayed for protection. In doing so, I was much comforted and began going out to investigate. But even now, as I went forward, I looked behind me frequently because I was still very brightened. However, as I went about for 2 or 3 days and saw nothing, I became a little bolder. I decided to go down to the shore again and examine the footprint once more. I decided to measure it with my own footmark. As I came closer to the footmark, I realized that it could not be my footprint because I had not come to this part of the beach since a long time. Secondly, as I placed my foot alongside the footprint, it seemed larger than my own. My fear returned. I went home again, believing that there was someone there. This island was inhabited. Okay children, let's see the summary. Robinson Crusoe had been living alone on an island for a long time because his ship had been destroyed by the sea. He wanted company to overcome his loneliness. One day, he saw a footprint on the sand. He was sure that it was the footprint of a man. He searched for more footprints but couldn't find any. He got frightened. He ran back to his cave. He could not sleep that night. He thought that the footprint would be one of the savages of the mainland who had wandered out to the sea in a small boat. What would happen if he came with other savages and killed him? He began to pray for protection. Now he felt a little bolder. He wanted to see the footprint again. So one day he went out to the seashore and decided to measure it with his own footmark. He came closer to it and realized that it was not his footprint because he had not come to that part of the beach. Moreover, the footprint was bigger than his own footprint. Now, he became sure that someone lived on the island. He got frightened again and went back to his cave. Okay, children, I hope you understand this lesson. Thanks for watching.